Hi, I'm Ben.
And I'm John.
Oh. Sorry. I don't know why I just froze. It's like, I guess the first time I actually froze, I mean, I've messed up quite a few times, but I've never, like...
Yeah, froze.
Like, yeah.
Oh my god, I'm on camera!
Like, camera shy, I mean, I ain't pretty or anything, but camera shy and our, like, fear of crowds and stuff, I've never had that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But, anyway, today, get together with OCB.
Reactions.
And, wow. Today we're not doing a song, we're just going to go and flagellate ourselves. That means whip, not anything dirty.
I know what it means, but it still just doesn't sound right.
Yeah, well, later I'll punish myself for this mess up.
Oh, that's what they're calling it now, punishment?
Yeah.
Now it's punishment instead of fidgeting?
Yeah,
hey, before we go on, please like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and share. Get the word out about our show, and then go down into the description, and there'll be a link to the video from today, and check everything else out also.
Yeah, we're returning to Papa Buddy One's list. This is the Safety Fire Old Souls. Yeah, I know, but...
I think you need to go back to bed.
Maybe. I mean, I like the fact that he just added some gravel to his voice and went rather than like, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, that should be more common, you know.
Yeah.
Going aggressive.
I'm sitting on the fence on this at the moment.
Right. I like it. I mean, I haven't decided to like, I really like it or it's like, nah, I like that. That's, if it goes, basically, if it's something I'm going to go revisit. Time will tell.
Yeah, it's. I mean, we're still early into the song.
Yeah.
I agree with you. I like the way he did with his voice, and it once again, this could be a production issue. It just seems like there's something weak about it at the same time.
I don't know. I mean, I think he's fine. I didn't really pick up on like that, but I mean that's.
But right now, at the moment, we don't know where the song's going to go. I'm going to give it a chance. I'm not saying I dislike it, but I'm not digging the guitar work a whole lot.
It's funny because like, when it's coming in, it's like I like the riff. You know, I like the melody. I think it's kind of cool that they're playing too many notes for the 4/4 time it's in.
Where my problem is I don't like... the staccato way that they're playing the arpeggio. It's too slow, it's too staccato. A computer could have written it. That's where I don't
okay,
like
I,
the
I
feel
can,
of it.
Yeah, I can see that.
But we don't know where it's gonna go right. Either, so.
Yeah. funny because it reminds me of like a whole bunch of different bands. Like they got, yeah. if they got mashed together, it's like the chorus. It's like, oh, so if you replace, like, if you have Rage Against the Machine and you replace the whiny twat that was their original singer or vocalist or whatever you want to call that dumbass, they could be good. It's like, because they have the off tempo, but it's, you know, driving and it's kind of like, yeah, it's a hook. And then the other stuff, it's like, they're watched by like, oh, that almost feels like a Yes song. And then, or that almost feels like this. So this one, it's like, it's a neat conglomeration of things.
Yes. I like the song. I do like it. And the more I hear the vocals, they're not as weak as I originally thought. I think maybe it's just the way I'm hearing it today or something.
Or it might have been how they came in right. off that, you know, kind of flowery riff.
The staccato guitar, the arpeggio, is still bugging me.
I kind of dig it.
It doesn't sound organic. It sounds like a computer did. You could do the same thing and let the notes ring. Or you could do the same thing and play the notes faster. It sounds very, you know...
like robotic?
Robotic, or... And don't... The rest of the song says otherwise. But that part to me, that part sounds untalented. It sounds like somebody practicing an arpeggio.
So you mean it's like this a skill rather than a talent,
or right?
Like they've developed the skill, but they don't have the you know.
I mean, because I'll say the rest of the song says otherwise. So it's just I understand that's how they wrote that part. That's how it was done. I just don't dig it, but.
I think I hear what you're talking about now.
No, that's not here.
Oh, it's not there?
Because they're at least speed picking the arpeggio, like each note of the arpeggio.
Because, they're doing a circular riff, but they're ignoring the drum accents. No, and it's like, that's kind of, it feels disjointed or separated.
No, if which I don't know if they'll do it again, but they've done it at least twice in the song now. If you listen closer, I think it's the exact same arpeggio, but they're doing it as individual notes, staccato. Oh, okay. I love that bass.
Yeah,
it sinks right into your soul.
Yeah, it's like I got completely sucked in as soon as that hit.
Yeah. Oh, seriously. When the water meets the sky, with the moon's sun, here is where we'll sell them. Made out where the water meets the sky.
And something about the moon, and then here's werewolves, I think he's saying.
Okay.
Which makes the song way cool.
This is really taking me back to something from the 80s. I just can't put my finger on it.
Vocally, he's pulling a little bit of a John Anderson yes-wise. And it's funny because I was going to wait till the end to make this comment, and I think it might be just because we heard it at the gas station on the way here. But it's like, this is like, what if Peter Gabriel was really pissed off with his weird ass?
Okay.
Okay, that outro was too long.
Yeah, it should not have dragged on that long and
faded out on top of it. But
I think it should have changed it up slightly, because it was okay. It was calming, but it was also getting boring.
Yeah, essentially my only real bitch about this song is the very end.
What's funny is what we had discussed. They never brought back again.
No.
And the more the song went on, the more I got into it.
Same.
The only dig I'm going to make is I was finding it kind of difficult to... I could make out certain keywords, but in between those keywords, it's like, whoa, what?
By the end of it, I don't think he's actually saying werewolves. But in my head, he's saying werewolves, and that makes it cooler. Like, the Werewolf 7, I think it's When the water meets the sky, the Werewolf 7's having dinner or something. But it's I just make up my own words. But it's I think this is one of those bands where one song's not enough to give you a real
feel
for the band, and or even have a real legit reaction.
Yeah.
It's just this song, I liked this song. The more it played, the more I liked it till the end. Then it, basically you had me, and then you lost me at the very end, but it's over. Who cares?
Yeah. Like I said, my original complaint about his vocals, it wasn't performance. necessary. Well, maybe it was performance. It wasn't. It was. I would have liked to have seen him maybe a little bit stronger. A little beefier or something.
Okay, okay.
And then, like I said, that one part where they were staccatoing the arpeggio, it just, when I'm being drawn into the song and then all of a sudden that's like, you know, smacking me around a little bit and pulling me back out of the song, I didn't have much appreciation for it. But they didn't do it again after we mentioned it the last time, so.
I mean, there's little things about, like, I'm being hypercritical. I have to be hypercritical to find things really about this song to like not like. So I should just stop because I just enjoyed the song. I'm reacting, not ripping apart,
but
dissecting this.
There was a lot of it that it's like, okay, it's very modern. They've got their own sound, but there's parts of it where it's like, this just has there's like an 80s band feel in there's here some, that.
After you said that,
but I couldn't put my finger on it.
I was like, okay, every band I mentioned that's wrong, and I don't know what the hell it is, because there was like one, like a couple lines that he sang, it's like, with the music, it's like, that's son of a bitch. I'll probably think of it like four days.
But
I'll just call you up like, is this?
You'll just message me on Messenger. Yeah. Anyways, you won't call me. Nobody calls me.
Nah, same here. I don't.
Except for like,
telemarketers and you know,
politicians.
Oh yeah, that's.
Thank God this election's over now.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna make any comments about like the red stop, whatever. It's like,
I'm not making a comment about the politics or politicians themselves, other than the fact that the commercials and the text messages and the phone calls and the emails were getting really, really annoying.
I mean, yeah, with especially the text messages, like, because texting back, eat a dick, constantly made my fingers sore.
Yeah.
It's like, no, eat a dick. I'm not.
I kept getting one for Maria. Hi, Maria, this is such and such. It's like, who is it? This has been my phone number for 4 years.
It's like, I mean, like, okay. If I got like a text message, it's like, vote for me and Madonna will suck your dick. It's like, okay, I'm not voting for you.
Yeah.
It's like, it's like,
I still want it attached. I don't want it to fall off. But
I don't want it to turn green. You know, it's like,
yeah.
But anyway, yeah, we're way off on a tangent.
Yes, we are, but it was fun.
Yeah.
No, not my favorite song, but I still liked it. I really had a good appreciation for it.
I mean, in the end, I liked it. In the end, because I know that's just one song, and they're going to...
They're worth checking out more.
I need more to make a real final decision on whether I like them or not. I mean, yes. I like the song. I will be checking out more by The Safety Fire, which that does annoy me that it's not Men Without Hats.
Yeah,
or like you can dance if you want to.
That's a safety dance, you
moron. Yeah, I know. But that made me think of that. So I'm like, damn it. I'm old too. So anyway, that's all I got to say about it.
Well, at least we're not mixing up Men Without Hats with Men at Work again.
Yeah, that's bad.
The difference between Canada and Australia.
Very minimal.
Distance.
Yeah.
And
one's hot, one's cold.
Yeah.
One where they can actually, you know, grow some vegetables, and the other one where it's like, well, I guess you're eating shrubbery and rabbits.
Yeah.
Maybe a Yeti.
Hey, before we close out, please like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and share. And go down into the description where there'll be a link to the video. And check out the other links that are down there also.
Fairly well.
Thank you.
Hey, when you get a chance to, go down into our description and check out our Cafe Press link for our t-shirt.